Hello everyone, welcome back to the next lesson of this free Figma course for complete beginners. My name is Ines, I have 15 years of experience in UX design, and in today's lesson we will be covering auto layouts. Now, we have partially discussed auto layouts in the previous lesson when we were talking about groupings in Figma. If you missed this lesson, I recommend you to watch it, because today we are going to dive deeper. Let's go! A reminder, auto layouts allow us to group objects in Figma in a way that we don't really need manually position them anymore in the group. Let me show you how. For example, we have this group of objects in our Figma, and to create an auto layout, we need to click here in the layout section. You can also use shortcuts, we discussed them last time, it's Command A. But today we're going to talk about this specific piece of Figma interface, because this is where we control auto layouts. Now, as I said already, auto layouts allow us to position and change objects inside of the group without manually doing so. What I mean by that is that if we need to create a duplicate of these objects within the group, we can just do so by clicking Command D or copy paste it, and it will take the logical place defined by the group settings. This is very convenient in many ways, because in UI design we often have a group of similar objects. But let's go into more details. Let's have a closer look to the auto layout panel. What do we have here? First, we have a group of inputs that control the width and the height. This is actually a very handy group of inputs, because you will be working with them a lot, and we're going to see how. Then you will have these arrows, and what do they do is that they define the layout. Now we have it set as the vertical one, and let's see what will happen if we change it to the horizontal. So now all objects are set into the horizontal line. Because the line has the predefined width, we see them all squeezed inside of this group. We will see what the next arrow called wrap is doing a bit later, because we will need to have some changes inside of our group. But first, let's go over all of the inputs. The next one is predefining the spacing between the objects inside of the auto layout. If I want to set it to 60, I can do it so here. And the next group of inputs is defining the paddings. And you can do so by defining them individually or by grouping them together. We will also see how they work a bit later. And the last piece here is the clip content button. We have reviewed it twice in the previous lesson, but shortly what it does, it clips the content that goes outside of the auto layout. Because the auto layout is just the same frame but only with benefits, we have this setting here. Right now, let's go and try out auto layouts in a very realistic scenario. We have an object and the text inside of it. Right now, they are not grouped in any ways. And it could be a button, it could be a tag, and we want them to be together. We can do so with auto layouts. But maybe if this is a tag, it's not exactly what we wanted, because we want it to be a bit condensed. We often want that the outside box is hugging the text. And here is the handy button in the auto layout section called Resize to Fit. There is also a shortcut for it, but honestly, it's pretty long and I'm not using it. But what this button does is that it changes the width and the height to the hugging mode. And this is exactly the place to discuss what this hug means. The hug will allow you to change the text within this button without breaking it. But you might have different needs, and sometimes it is convenient when the button is actually having the fixed width. You can do so by either changing the size and then the hug will go automatically, or by predefining the size within this input and then it will be automatically fixed. Now you can have your button taking the whole space of your mobile screen. There is a bit more to the topic of width and height, but for that we will need to have a group of objects. For example, we have these tags that are aligned in the horizontal layout. They are all grouped in the auto layouts on top of themselves being an auto layout. And now, when we have the situation like that, we can define for some objects inside of the auto layout that they will be filling container. How this will change the behavior? Now, if we change the size of the group, you will see that the object that we set as fill container will really fill the container, whereas others will stay in place and will stay being hugged. In many situations when we work with responsive design, it is actually very helpful. And designing your auto layouts, you need to think upfront, how do you want your objects to behave? That comes with practice, and if you are not sure, hug everything together, and once you change the size, you can always set it to fill. Because nothing will be broken if you just change this one to the fixed one, or you can change it to hug, and then nothing will happen if you change the width of your original auto layout. Now a small tip for you, I double clicked on the auto layouts frame and now it is hugged again. By the way, if you like this free Figma course for complete beginners and you don't want to miss on the next lesson, click the subscribe button down below and hit the bell. This way you will get a notification when a new lesson comes out. Okay, time to talk about what this arrow does. And this arrow called wrap. If it is a very convenient setting, if you have a group of objects like we do, and you want to add more objects, but you don't want them to go beyond your frame. If you have your wrap setting on, you can change the width of your auto layout and you see what has happened. The last tag has jumped to the next line. With many situations, as with tags, for example, it is very convenient because we can work with responsiveness without breaking the layout, without spilling over certain objects outside of your frame. We have an auto layout inside of the frame, and we might want it to be dependent on the width of your frame. You might want your auto layout group to mimic the width of your parent frame, so that you change the size of your parent frame and the group changes and those objects, they jump down the line. You can do so by using constraints, and we have discussed constraints in the previous lesson when we discussed the groupings. And now what will happen if you change the size of your frame? This is the screen size, for example. Your objects will be jumping logically. Awesome, right? I really like this feature of Figma. It allows me to be really flexible and to build my responsive designs really, really fast. So it's worth spending time and really mastering auto layouts. Now, auto layouts themselves have constraints too. You see that here they have almost exactly the same looking piece as there on the top. And what these pieces do is that it will allow to predefine the place of the objects inside of the auto layout, so it will define the position. It will also work for horizontal and vertical layouts, and it's very convenient. And now, finally, the last setting group we have in this panel. It is very rare when I personally use this setting, but they are very, very convenient because they handle very narrow use cases. And the first use case is when you have a stroke on your object and you might want to exclude it or include it in the auto layout. Honestly, I don't really know when you will need this. I have never used this setting myself, but it's nice to have it there and it's also nicely visualized, so you don't really need to have it in mind. You can see how it will change your layout immediately. The second one I actually use quite sometimes. It predefines the stacking. There is sometimes a need to create a group of avatars, like we have it on the visualization. And we might want to have the first avatar coming on top or the last avatar coming on top. Honestly, except of this use case, I don't really know when you will be using that, but it's also very handy because this use case is really a common one. By the way, you can actually create the exact view that we have in the auto layout settings when your objects are placed one over another by setting a negative spacing. This is maybe worth mentioning as well because it's not very obvious. So I might want to have this situation and now you see that they are placed one over another. But let's finish with the auto layout settings. And the last one is a very simple one. It allows us to align text baselines. And honestly, I've never used that. I'd never had this use case, but it could also be very handy. And again, you have here a visualization in case you will forget what it defines. And that was it about auto layouts. Honestly, this is my favorite topic. This is the tool I use the most in Figma. And I really recommend you spending time and mastering this part. Because in my opinion, there are no other parts in Figma that speed up your work so significantly. Some tools of Figma you can touch only once or twice a year, like variables, for example, and no worries, we're going to have a lesson about them. But auto layouts are really everywhere. I hope you liked this lesson and now you know how to work with auto layouts. Let me know in the comments if anything is unclear. And if you don't want to miss next lessons in this free Figma course for complete beginners, hit the subscribe button down below and click the bell. This way you will receive a notification when a new lesson comes out. And I see you next time.